Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In this video, we're going to talk about color lookup tables. Color lookup tables allow us to apply a photographic effect with the click of a button. Color lookup tables are usually used in video, but you can use them in Photoshop as well. You can create a color lookup table adjustment by clicking on the new adjustment layer icon and selecting color lookup. This is going to give you these options here with three different dropdowns, and each of these dropdowns is going to contain a list of LUT files, lookup tables, and you can select any one of these, for example, film stock, and that applies a effect to the image. Another one that I like is teal orange. This is more of that movie look effect. And lookup tables really don't have any settings. Once you apply it, you really don't have anything to adjust besides the usual adjustments that you can do to any layer, for example, the opacity or the blend mode. Some of the blend modes that I like using alongside lookup tables are soft light, overlay, and luminosity and color. Let's talk about color first. Color allows you to keep the colors found in the lookup table, but the luminosity of your original layer. Luminosity allows you to use the luminance values of the lookup table, but the colors of the original layer. And of course, you can try any of the other blend modes just in case you find something that you like. I'm going to come back into the normal channel, and I'm just quickly going to show you a few others. For example, edgy amber and night from day. So as you can see, lookup tables can be very useful, especially when you start implementing them with opacity and different blend modes. And as I mentioned earlier, you have more under the other two drop-down menus, for example, these here, and these here as well. And now that we're talking about the drop-downs, one of the things that I do have to mention is that the abstract drop-down is different between the Mac and PC versions of Photoshop. The Mac version of Photoshop contains more color lookup tables, so you can apply more effects if you are on the Mac. This is a screenshot comparing the two different versions. As you can see, there's more on the Mac. So this is actually one of the few differences in Photoshop between Mac and PC. There aren't too many, but this is one of them. Anyway, not only can you use the lookup tables that come with Photoshop, you can create your own. Let me show you how you can create your own lookup table. I'm going to delete that layer, and you can create a lookup table by using adjustment layers. Any one of these adjustment layers will help you create a lookup table. For example, the curves adjustment layer, I can use that to apply medium contrast to the image. Then I can use another curves adjustment layer, and maybe this time I'll set it to color so we only affect the color of the image and not the luminance values. We'll go into the blue channel, and we'll add some blue to the dark colors and some yellow to the brighter colors. Then I'll go into the red channel and I'll add some cyan to the dark colors and some red to the brighter colors. If I think the effect is too strong, I can also bring down the opacity just a bit. And I can even use fill layers, a solid color, to create a lookup table. So maybe I can select a green color, maybe a color like this one, press OK, and then choose soft light. And I don't want this adjustment to affect the blacks and whites, so I'm going to double click to the right side of the layer to bring up the layer style window, and we're going to use the blend diff sliders and use the luminosity of these layers to decide where to apply the adjustments. So hold Alt Option on the Mac to split the two blend diff sliders, which use luminance values of the layer you're on or the underlying layer to hide the effect of the layer you have selected. In this case, by splitting these two in half by holding Alt Option on the Mac, you can make the effect fade in the dark area. So that's what I'm doing. And I also want to do that in the brighter areas. Alt Option on the Mac, click, split those into two, and you see how the effect starts disappearing in the brighter areas. So that's before, and that's after. I'm going to press OK. And again, this might be a little too strong, so I'm going to bring down the opacity just a bit, maybe around 67%. And maybe this is the effect that I want to go for. This is going to be my new LUT file. I'm going to select the top layer, hold Shift, click on the bottom one, Then press Command G on the Mac to turn that into a group. With the group selected, I'm going to show you how to export a lookup table. But this first time, it's not going to work, and you'll see why in a moment. I'm going to go into File, Export, Color Lookup Tables, and Photoshop is going to tell me that it cannot create the lookup table because there's no background found. I'm going to press OK. So I'm going to click on Layer 0 and go into Layer, New, Background from Layer. And that turns this layer into a background. Notice the word background here and the icon of a lock to the right. You may already have a background layer, but in case you're working with layers, I wanted to show you how to create a background layer. So now we're going to click on the group, which is our lookup table. So I'll just call this LUT, just so we know what that is. And then I'm going to go into File, Export, Color Lookup Tables. You can enter a description. I can just call it lookuptables.psd. That's fine. You can enter a copyright if you like and use lowercase file extensions if you like. I usually have this checked. The quality high is good for me. And this is the format, the file type that you're going to use to create that LUT file. More often than not, you probably are going to use ICC profile simply because that profile is not color mode dependent, meaning I can use it with any color mode, RGB, CMYK, LAB, whatever you have. If you don't use ICC, you might also want to use Cube, but I'll leave ICC for now. Then I'm going to press OK. Photoshop is going to ask me where I want to save the lookup table files. That's fine for me here. So I'm just going to click on Save, and that's going to save my lookup table. Now I'm going to disable the visibility of the group that I created. Then I'm going to go into Color Lookup, and I'm going to load the lookup table that we just created. If you created an ICC file like I did, then you're going to find it under device link. If not, you're going to probably find it under here. So just click on Load 3D LUT. In this case, I'm going to click on Load Device Link Profile and click on the .icc file. Then I'm going to click on Load, and Photoshop is immediately going to load that lookup table and the same look we had before. I'm going to click on the background layer, drag it over to a new layer icon to duplicate it, put that on top of the LUT folder, and I'm just going to select these two files by holding Shift and clicking on both, pressing Control G, Command G, and the Mac to turn that into a group. Now we have all the layers enabled, so we can see both versions. As you can see, there is no difference. The same color effect that we created by applying these three adjustment layers is now being applied by one color lookup table adjustment layer. And of course, with this adjustment layer, you can still use the opacity and different blend modes. Keep in mind that when you're creating lookup tables, you can pretty much use all of these adjustment layers, including a color lookup table adjustment layer. So you can create lookup table adjustment layers by using other color lookup adjustment layers. And now that you've created your own lookup table, you can not only use it in Photoshop, but you can use it in Adobe After Effects, Adobe Premiere, Adobe SpeedGrade, and many other applications that use color lookup tables. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video with a friend. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.